Hello and welcome back everyone to another tutorial on Tableau. This series of videos will help you take your skills from beginner to expert level in Tableau. Do not forget to hit the red subscribe button and the bell icon so that you are the first one to know whenever I upload any new video. In today's session, we will see how to create progress bar charts in Tableau. Progress bar chart is a good way to show how much progress you have made on a scale of 0 to 100% towards a goal. Let me show you an example first. Here I have a bar chart that shows the percentage scored by 10 students of a class on a scale of 0 to 100%. So Rob, who has scored 87% in the class, has a bar that is filled up to 87% out of the total 100%. And similarly for all the other students. So by the end of this tutorial, you will be able to create a view similar to this one. Now let's jump to Tableau and see how to create a progress bar chart. For this tutorial, I am using the students' performance dataset. In this dataset, I have marks of 10 students in 5 different subjects and the final percentage that the student has scored. So the columns that are present in the dataset are name of the student, then the gender of the student, then marks scored by the student in 5 different subjects, maths, English, science, social studies, and French, then the total marks and the percentage that they have scored. Using this dataset, we need to find out who has scored the highest percentage. So we will use progress bar chart to display the percentage of all the 10 students. Now let's go to sheet 1. Now first drag student name to column shelf. Next we will drag percentage to row shelf. Let's turn on the labels by clicking on show marks label button. We have to show these numbers in the form of percentage. So let's change the default display format of percentage column in terms of percentage. Go to percentage, click on the drop down. From here, go to default properties, number format, click on percentage. We don't want to display any decimal places. Click on OK. Now we are getting the labels in the form of percentage. Let's arrange these bars in descending order. Now to create 100% filled bar chart, we will write down in the row shelf average of 1. So these bars will act as the white colored bars which will complete all these bars up to 100%. Let me show you. So here you will observe that we have white colored bars. So they are basically completing these blue colored bars to 100%. Go back to the sheet 1. Now drag this field that we have created to percentage axis and drag measure names to color, and next go to analysis, stack marks, and switch off the stack marks. Let's change the color of average 1 field to white. Double click on orange. Again double click here. From here we will select white color, click on OK, click on OK again, click anywhere outside the chart. So the bars are not visible to us. Let's add a border to the bars. Go to color under mark section. From here select border and we will select this blue color. Here you will observe that we have a progress bar chart that shows the percentage scored by the students on a scale of 0 to 100%. Next, we need to add the labels on the blue bars to show what was the percentage that was scored by the student. Let me show you. So this type of percentage label we will be adding on our filled bar charts. Go back to the sheet 1. So to add the labels, we will create a dual axis chart. So drag percentage column next to the measure values in the row shelf. Now make this a dual axis chart by clicking on the drop down and select dual axis. Now change the mark type of percentage field to circle and synchronize both the axes by right click on axis and select synchronize axis. Now we will increase the size of these circles. Increase the size of the circle so that they are coming out of the bars. Let's also decrease the size of these bars. Go to the measure values, go to size, and let's adjust the size. Okay, now the view looks good. Now we will change the color of these blue circles to white. Make sure that percentage field is selected. Remove measure names from here. Now go to color and select white. So you will see that we are getting white color circles and a blue background. Now we need to add these labels that we are getting inside the circle to make a good looking progress bar chart. So we will go to label, change the alignment, click this center. So now we are getting labels inside the circles. Let's hide these axes. Right click, uncheck show header. Let's hide this axis as well. Right click, uncheck show header. Let's hide these labels as well. So make sure measure values is selected. Go to labels and uncheck show mark labels. Let's hide this name field label, right click and click on hide field labels. Now let's also remove these grid lines. Right click, click on format, go to borders, select none for row divider, then select none for column divider. Now go to lines, we are getting grid lines in between. Select none for axis stick, select none for zero lines. Next go to rows. From here we will remove these grid lines, select none. Let's change the view to entire view. Now if you want this header to come at the top of the bars, we can go to analysis, then go to table layout. Next click on advanced. Now uncheck this show innermost level, click on OK. So now you will observe that we are getting the headers at the top of the bars. Now let's remove this tooltip that we are getting on the bar. Go to the measure values, go to tooltip, here remove all this and click on OK. So now you will observe that we are getting the tooltips only when we hover on the percentage circles. So in this way you can create a progress bar chart and add labels at the end of the blue bars to show how much progress is made on a scale of 0 to 100%. So this was all that I had to cover in this session. I hope this session was useful. I have added the dashboard link in the description below. Do not forget to hit the thumbs up button if you like this session. See you in the next video.